Holy crap! Look at this storm coming in here. Wow.
You got more.
Oh, more anchor bolts.
Yeah, you got supply
on the back. Oh, perfect. Looks like it might be a shop day, boys.
Yeah.
Yeah, look at.
How about that lawn rolling, Andrew?
Yeah, I think it's a little wet for lawn rolling.
Yeah.
Maybe tomorrow. Okay, I'm getting wet right here.
Keep it up with the Joneses, still have to
wait. Yep, tomorrow will be a good day for the lawn rolling. Wow. You don't want to smoke in the caddy because you don't want to wreck it or something. I think it's more because of the gas fumes. Oh, yeah, that cigarette makes you look cool.
Oh yeah, especially with these safety glasses.
Oh, you know what's even better is you got that twinkle in your eye right there. Look at this. Look, you got something on you. We'll smudge that off.
Why not?
So yeah, we're getting all this rust out of this Cadillac here. What do you think? What do you have to say for yourself?
Oh, I'm enjoying it. I'm having fun.
Look at this. Night and day difference, eh? Wow. Right down to the... I finally broke down and bought one of those wire wheels for the angle grinder. You know, I thought that I acquired one in the shop, but look at the... Before and after. Yeah, the before and after. So yeah, we're gonna cut out all the rusty areas and then we're even gonna sandblast it yet, you know, just to get everything off, get it all perfect. We got some tar still there underneath the pedals. So yeah, we got the template as to what we gotta repair, so.
Now you can actually see what you need to repair.
Yeah. I mean, we'll redo the wiring, whatnot, because that's just a rat's nest. Well, actually, it was a mouse nest. There was a mouse in here once upon a time. There was a few.
A few.
But yeah, what a difference. Yeah, what a difference, eh? Wow, I'm liking what I'm seeing. There's the floors. All right, make a big cloud.
Make a big cloud?
Yeah.
Alrighty.
See us thing in action.
Smoke myself out again.
Yeah, you already smoked yourself out once. It was raining. I said, "Oh, you can open up all the doors, and then I'll get rid of the smoke there."
Smoked myself out quite a few times.
Yeah, but yeah, caddy's coming along. Caddy's coming along.
Or you'll get some more light in here.
Yeah. Okay, so you buy an engine from an R-wrecker, right?
Yep.
And so you say to them, like, oh, you know, do you know anything about the car? Of course, they don't know anything about it. But yep, run good.
That's what they know. It runs good.
Runs good. Okay, so you take the guy's word on it.
Anyways, that was the first mistake.
Yeah, that was the first mistake. So then, you know, it has, you can see that the clutch that had like a, what would you call it? It had a vibration. The flywheel had
Yeah, it had a major vibration.
Yeah,
it was just the crankshaft, but
yeah,
no, we were wrong.
Yeah, we thought that maybe like a bearing had gone at it because they let the flywheel go so bad on the thing.
Yeah, so we had it on the engine stand. We tore off the bottom. We took out the old crankshaft, put in a new one.
No. Well, what we did is we took the auto wrecker's word, right?
Oh, yeah.
You know, because they stand behind their product, right?
Of course.
Well, lo and behold, look at what happened. Look at this. Got this one's all cracked. This was missing altogether. Anyways, yeah, I think that valve has dropped, actually. Because look, it's not even up. So yeah, this head has to be taken to the machine shop. Now it's all scraped and everything, the camshaft. Oh, I'm going to show the intake. You'll see the intake and EGR were just caked. let's see here. Ugh. Look at all that baked on goodness. This thing could barely breathe. EGR looks okay on the one end. Look on the other end. Wow, that's just sad. That's just sad. But anyways, so you buy an engine, take someone's word on it, and look at what happens. This is after installing the engine, so we took it out, and it's just easier to fix it up that way. So now we have a brand new bottom end. We have a crank inspected by machine shop. We have new bearings. We have new connecting rod bearings. And now we're about to peel this head off because I wonder what else is wrong with this. So now, yeah, it ate the cam. The cam was basically scored and it was chewed up a bit. So yeah, we're going to be taking this head off. Yeah, it was running like garbage. And
pistons are all good.
Yeah, the pistons look all good.
Let's see the bottom side of the head, Rambo.
Yeah, let's see
that.
Oh, yeah. Yeah, see, there's nothing retaining that one.
That one hit my hand.
That one was just along for the ride. It's gonna fall out.
Yeah.
And it was a one notch too, so it was a more high performance one. I normally use the two notch, but yeah, we'll take that head to the machine shop and get them to do their thing on it. Yeah, so wow, look at all that oil and everything too. It looked like it had a little bit of a leak.
Mm-hmm.
Wow. Well, that sucks. So now I gotta put another head on this thing. Luckily we have one from the machine shop the other day. I got those two blocks in there. So now I have a head shortage. So that one that we got cooked in the fire, dropped that off. So hopefully we'll get that sometime soon for one of those blocks. So yeah, we'll have a brand new engine when we're done with this. New water pump, new timing belt, new reconditioned head, new bottom end, and a nice clean oil pan. So yeah, that's the way she goes.
New everything.
New everything.